few minutes ago, just prior to activating all of this electronic equipment, thus bringing us together by radio, I remembered something that I neglected to do. And that was to pray for this program. I got so tied up in busyness this morning that my whole schedule seemed to go awry, so here we are, with each other through the miracle of electronics. I'm Bill Pearce, and you happen to be in tune with the program Night Sounds. We come on, as is suggested, late at night. Now and then after midnight into the early hours of the morning. For the most part, darkness is around us. And I often begin our program by asking both of us to reflect for a few moments on the day past. As you look at your life and perhaps what you did today, what was the motivating factor? What drove you to do what you're doing? Could have been an emergency. It could be just basic necessity of making a living. Tonight's program is entitled Autopilot. And that's a familiar word to many people who travel and are familiar with the jargon of avionics and flying. Autopilot is something that's come along in the past few years where, in a sense, a plane can fly itself. Mid-flight, landing, the whole thing. It's a marvelous invention. But you know, that's been around for a long time. And tonight's program, Autopilot, we're going to be bringing in flight, but a very unusual kind of flight plan and flight pattern. Autopilot. Stay tuned, because it can touch a human life. And the overtones are tremendous. Right now I'm going to turn to our music agenda. It's not often that I play pure country sound, but I think some of it, when it's done well, is very appealing. Here's Susan Ashton to open with a very compelling account of a young man, 21 years of age, who, well, he began to make his decisions and certain things began to motivate him the wrong way. But we'll just bring in the music and let her tell the story. It's entitled The Call of the Wild. Let's stay tuned.
He was 21 when he got married. His son was born when he was 23. He watched his reckless days of youth turn to years of responsibility. His world became routine and he got restless. The family ties that bind just tied him down. He felt his life was passing by him. He felt his dreams were crashing to the ground.
country style there tonight to open our program, Susan Ashton. The song entitled Call of the Wild. And tonight's program entitled Autopilot. I'm Bill Pearce and this is Night Sounds, and many of you have been along with us for a good many years. It's a real privilege to be able to contact you in this way. Tonight's program, Autopilot, we began speaking about flight, because that certainly is what the word would suggest. Actually, it's around the subject of divine leading. And a while ago, when I asked you what drove you or motivated you to do what you did today, and I asked myself the same question, we'll come up with a plethora of answers. But I'd like to theologize this particular togetherness right now. Because the Bible, God's revealed word, lets us know that He creates things out of nothing. He created the first human being out of the dust of the ground. There can be no life without antecedent life. In other words, nothing can begin to exist in and of itself. It has to have the divine energy to activate it. As we're speaking of flight, and of course many of our thoughts might go back to Kitty Hawk, the Wright brothers, some of the foiled attempts of man trying to copy the birds of the air for so many, many centuries. But the Bible reveals to us various principles which God used in the creation through His Word, by will, from nothing, spontaneously through Jesus Christ. Some time ago, a listener to Night Sounds sent us a fascinating account of one of God's creations. Just taking a look at it, its authenticity and validity is engendered by Psalm 104, verse 24, which reads, O Lord, how manifold are thy works! In wisdom thou hast made them all. The earth is full of thy riches. We encounter these works, so wisely conceived, at every turn. And tonight, just considering one particular example, the flight of migratory birds, the miracle of energy. Taking a little bit closer look at this phenomenon, every process, whether in physics, technology, or biology, adheres strictly to the law of conservation of energy, which means any work to be done requires a certain amount of energy supplied. The problem facing migratory birds is that of taking with it sufficient fuel, equaling fat, to complete its journey. To ensure the necessary flying capacity, the bird must be as light a build as possible. Excess weight is to be avoided at all costs, so the use of fuel has to be as efficient as possible. How do you think the Creator, our God, made the fuel last so long without refilling? Well, I guess the first step would be to choose the most economical cruising speed. If this bird flies too slowly, it would consume too much fuel simply to stay airborne. If it flies too slowly, it would consume too much fuel simply by staying airborne. If it flies too fast, it wastes too much energy in overcoming resistance in air. So we see that there's a definite minimum for the consumption of fuel, and a definite minimum for the consumption of energy. So, depending on the aerodynamics, the optimal speed is different for each bird. It's a known fact that birds gear themselves exactly to this energy-saving speed. And how do they know? Well, scientists say this is one of the many unsolved ornithological puzzles. There's a bird that is called the golden plover. Now, this bird migrates from Alaska to Hawaii for the winter. And its nonstop flight takes it across the open sea where there's no island. And in addition, the bird cannot swim, so that a stop for rest is impossible. The flight is over 4,000 kilometers. And this is an incredible 250,000 consecutive wing beats lasting 88 hours. And the bird's starting weight is 200 grams, of which 70 are stored as layers of fat to be used as fuel. From what I understand, the golden plover converts 6% per hour of its current body weight. The mathematics in this whole scene, staggering. And we won't get into that for sure. I was not the strongest math scholar ever. But it's astonishing when we consider that corresponding value for man-made mechanic flying is absolutely incredible, too. How does this bird know how much fat is necessary? How does it arrange to have this amount just before the journey? How does the bird know this distance and the specific rate of fuel consumed? And how does he know the way? How does he navigate? Even a slight diversion off course while crossing the ocean would mean certain death in the open sea for migrating land birds. The vast majority of migrating birds would never reach their destination without navigational methods. And no species could survive such an overwhelming loss rate. So, any suggestion that evolution played a part must be totally dismissed. Also, the suggestion that young birds learn the way flying with their parents carries a little weight, as many species fly solo. It's thought then that migratory birds have an instinctive sense of direction, like a compass, which makes it possible for them to orientate themselves and keep flying in a certain direction. This is mind-staggering tonight, and I'm just going to be bringing music in and out of our commentary. The song Give Them All to Jesus. We're playing trombone here with the Singers Unlimited. And ultimately, when we arise in the morning and begin our day with all of the ablutions and the schedule demands and communication with families and friends and whatever we have to do to get moving and get underway requires vital energy, a thought process, some wisdom, some decisions to be made. And that's what this song is all about. Because in this particular location of life, as we are underway and functioning and connecting, contributing, inventing, using our reason and all of the strength and all of the assets, we want to give them all back to the Creator who has given them to us, investing in His mighty power and creative energy. Let's listen to the music and the words, because this particular action comes from the will of the human being. So where do we take all of this? How do we direct it? Well, the chorus comes along right now to tell us.
Give them all, give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, and broken toys. Give them all, give them all, give them all. Jesus, and He will turn your sorrow into joy, into joy.
Album Touch of Gold, the commemorative double CD from Nightsounds, the song Give Them All to Jesus. You're in tune with the program Nightsounds. I'm Bill Pearce with you via radio. Once again tonight, very gratefully so. And our subject at hand is one word, autopilot. A word that brings the image of flying. But we're not speaking of 747s or the old DC-3 or any kind of man-made operation. We're speaking about migratory birds covering thousands of miles by God's creation and direction. They're on autopilot. They're not conscious of it, but they're doing it. We'll be back to this in just a moment. We'll be leaving the airwaves in a few minutes. But when we do, we want to leave something tangible with you as ministry until we return to each other again. The CD that I mentioned, a double album, and this album, which was chronologically produced in styles and songs and music, chronology, the arrangers, the studios, and the whole thing, the whole pattern of flight. If you'd like information, we would urge you to write us. Our mailing address, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Also a companion booklet entitled Golden Moments, taken from Personal Devotions in the Morning, where we write in a journal. Our mailing address, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Tonight's program is a fascinating one, I think, autopilot, speaking of divine guidance and citing migratory birds. The famous Danish ornithologist Finn Solomonsen said about a bird's orientation during migration these words: "The bird's ability to find its way during migration is surely the greatest mystery. Seldom has another question given so much cause for theorizing and speculation as this one. Indeed, this navigational achievement, performed without complex boards of instruments, compass, map, under constantly changing conditions, including sun position, wind direction, cloud cover, the diurnal cycle, it's an incomparable miracle. Even a slight diversion off course, crossing the ocean, as we mentioned, would be death in the open sea. And the vast majority of migrating birds would never reach their destination without navigational methods." That's the absolutely incredible factor. The birds go in different directions. There have been trials and experiments to get them off course, turning things around. Even when birds are anesthetized for this outward journey, or if their cages were made to rotate continuously, so their orientation was constantly changing, they were just as able to find their way home as were the control birds. This method of determining location, not understood even today, is only the beginning. Then comes the real problem, namely flight navigation. During flight over wide, windswept stretches of ocean, a tendency to drift off course cannot be avoided. God has put in the individual parts of His creation, their life support system, their motivation, the energy needed. His balance is absolutely incredible. And whatever bondage we happen to be in, He can free us and put us in the center of His divine guidance system. There's an old song that I'd like to ask Cynthia Clawson to sing for us tonight. Many of you will remember this. Let's recall what was said tonight about migrating birds, the half of which has not yet been spoken, on this program or anywhere else, it seems. But let's just bring this into a theological focus right now. Cynthia Clawson to sing one of the old ones. Out of my bondage, sorrow, misdirection, of whatever night, where do we go with it?
Out of my shameful failure and loss, Jesus, I come. Jesus, I come into the glorious gate. Jesus, I come to thee. Out of earth's sorrows, into thy balm, out of life's storms, distress to jubilant song, Jesus, I come to thee, Jesus, I come to
the Creator equipped these birds of which we've been speaking tonight with a precise autopilot, which apparently is constantly measuring its geographical position, comparing the data with its individuality, its programmed destination. In this way, an economical energy saving and direct flight is guaranteed. Just where this vital system is to be found, how its operating information is coded, is known by no one today except the Creator who made it, them, us, and all living things. Wouldn't it be the better part of wisdom to turn our entire lives over to Him? Let's do it right now. If we've never done it before, those who have, rededicate our energy to Him. In Jesus' name. Thank you so much for being with me tonight. Our mailing address, Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Till we meet again for the next flight, God bless and good night.